Listening to the BBC World Service, this is NewsHour, coming to you live from London with James Kimaresamy. We're going to get more now on our main story, the new major UN-backed report into biodiversity, with its conclusion that mankind is pushing nature to the brink. We often hear about the impact that the loss of forests has on the climate and on the ecosystems within them. But according to the UN report, areas such as marshes, bogs and swamps are faring worse than forests, with human development severely altering or destroying 85% of the world's wetlands. Jane Madgwick is Chief Executive of Wetlands International, which is based in the Netherlands.
Wetlands are essentially the water systems in the landscape. So they're not just special sites for nature, but they're, for example, where water comes from, the water source. They're also the regulators of water, so affecting the quality and flow of water. They're also the biggest natural carbon stores on the planet. That's a fact that's very often overlooked because people are aware of forests, but actually twice as much carbon is stored in wetlands than in all the world's forests, even though they occupy a much smaller area of the land surface. So they're absolutely crucial in terms of mitigating against climate change.
And according to this report, just like the forests, humans are doing a lot to severely alter or indeed destroy the wetlands.
Yep, wetlands are disappearing faster than any other ecosystem, which is a major problem, not only for biodiversity, which, you know, they support 40% of biodiversity, so it's really significant, but also because wetlands are the ecosystem which provides the biggest range of services to people. And that's particularly because of the water function that I mentioned. So, for example, agriculture absolutely depends on there being healthy wetlands in the landscape because, yeah, you can't grow food without water. It's a massive crisis. Of course, this isn't a great surprise to Wetlands International, but I think this report adds something to the narrative.
What has caused the crisis and what can be done to avert it, if that's possible?
Many different kinds of threats. Drainage, when, for example, peatlands are drained, it causes major problems in terms of greenhouse gas emissions, subsidence, etc. Why does it happen? Yeah, diverse range of reasons. Very often wetlands are built on or converted because the values that they do have are not very well recognised. They're seen as wastelands even in some areas.
So how much of this is something that individuals can influence, or is it mainly down to governments?
I think there's a lot that individuals can do. I mean, wetlands are in every country in the world. Everybody knows a local wetland. And in fact, to do what this report is calling for, which is, you know, to transform our relationship with nature, to transform the nature of the landscape, then we need everybody to act. We need all different sectors to act at all scales. It starts very often with local people taking action by influencing their local government and then through to perhaps regional or national government.
What sort of action?
Reversing drainage, for example. We're involved in supporting local communities in Indonesia, in Russia, all over the place, in actually reversing the drainage, re-wetting.
This is about rethinking man's relationship to the planet, though, isn't it? It does require a big leap, I guess, for many individuals and governments.
Totally. I really like the way that this report emphasises that we need a new relationship with nature. You know, nature isn't some esoteric concept for the well-off to worry about. You know, it's fundamental life support for people on the planet.
One report isn't going to change everything, but does it give you some degree of optimism that this has been collated and that this is clearly calling for a change of thinking?
Yes, but partly because of the timing, you know, because there is a big awakening on the urgency to tackle climate. But actually, their narrative also says that this is related to ecosystems as well. And that's what I hope this report will kind of hammer home, that these are absolutely connected. You can't hope to tackle climate change without building back robust ecosystems in the landscape.
That was Jane Madgwick, the Chief Executive of Wetlands International.